Yeah, appreciate being here, you guys being here, and ready for a great year for us. And last year was a lot of fun for me. You know, it was my first opportunity as a head coach, and for me, you know, the impression that I want to make and have on young men is something where I help them develop, not just on the basketball court, but off of it as well. And I think that we've done that. And so I'm ready for the new challenge of this year with, you know, seven newcomers, including in that Tijon Lucas and Harrison Henderson, who I'll probably have to sit out this year. And with that comes a lot more teaching, similar to, you know, what took place last year when I first got the job and coming on board. The summer and the fall was really good. Our guys are working extremely hard. They're giving me everything that I'm asking them to do out there on the floor. And, you know, some of the takeaways from last year that we're carrying forward with us this year is, you know, the biggest thing that I care about is our toughness, and I care about our chemistry and togetherness. And, you know, I think that's what wins ball games. You know, the thing that I talk about with our team all the time is, you know, the toughest teams set the standard for winning. And so, you know, that's certainly something that we've tried to instill in our guys this year and this fall, and looking forward to carrying that into our games coming up. Our practices have been extremely intense and tough, and you know, so I'm excited to finally get an opportunity to play against somebody else other than ourselves. I'm sure our guys are tired of beating up on each other too. You know, with that, with our personnel, we have, like I said, seven newcomers. They've added length, they've added an ability to shoot the basketball, which is something that you can always improve. And from that standpoint as well, we have big guys that I think that can step out and shoot, although I don't want them, you know, shooting that all the time. But in today's landscape and how the game is played, you want more or as much spacing as you possibly can get out there on the floor. And if we do that, if we're capable of or able to shoot the ball a lot better, it gives our guards an opportunity to have a little bit more space and a little bit more room. We do want to try to increase the pace and score and get up tempo and as much as we can. And I always tell our guys, sometimes that first look that's open is probably going to be the best shot in our offensive scheme. So I encourage our guys to shoot that. I try to give them a ton of confidence with their game. So I'm excited about the start. I can't wait. You know, we have our exhibition games coming up and a couple scrimmages, and then we get started on November 6th against Boston College. I look at everything as an opportunity to improve and get better. I cherish the opportunities to teach. So with new guys, and they've all been great, it's given me an opportunity to teach some more and to help our guys get better. You know, there's no question you want the continuity, you want, you know, some of the semblance of guys that have been here, but we still have some guys that played last year and have returned. So they've been extremely good with our newcomers in helping them to, you know, assimilate into what we're doing, our culture and all of those things. So, you know, I look forward to that. You know, there are going to be some challenges with that. You always, chemistry is going to be the first thing while you're playing. I think our guys love each other and you know, love being around each other. But then it's another thing on the floor to really learn each other's game and where everyone's going to be out there on the floor. So I look forward to, once we are able to play somebody else, gathering that film and trying to figure out what's the best way that we can play and how we can infuse everyone into our schemes. Well, I think Boston's a lot of Irish people in Boston, so we wanted to follow that up with Belfast as well. But we're looking forward to, you know, to those challenges, and obviously that's going to tell a lot about our team, and that's what you want, is you want to learn as much as you possibly can from your toughest challenges. And Boston College in the ACC and Cincinnati in the AAC, you know, that's as tough of a challenge as you're going to get, and not to mention even our mid-major opponents. You know, when we go out to Belfast, we'll be playing Buffalo, an NCAA tournament team. We'll be playing, as part of the Belfast Classic, LIU Brooklyn. and Albany has been in the tournament. So we're going to be playing a lot of NCAA caliber teams. And, you know, I relish that. I look forward to that. I think our guys want that as well. And we'll see how you know, once those games, you know, finish and we're getting into those at least, we'll see where we're at. But I think it's a great challenge. I think our guys love it. And if you're coaching or playing, you don't want to shortchange your guys by playing, you know, opponents that won't challenge you, you know, throughout the year. No, I really like that. You know, I really like it. It's you know, Green Bay, obviously, you know, I had my start there in Division I at Green Bay, and you know, we have a few local guys on our team here, and just, you know, that right away will get our, I know it'll pique my interest right away, you know, playing against them. And certainly our guys that aren't from the area will understand that from me and from our other guys that are local and understand that rivalry. I think it's always good to play an in-state school like Wisconsin, and hopefully we can pick up that game again next year and the following years. But, you know, I think our guys really look forward to games against them. And like I said, I think and hope that it becomes something that we do every single year. I think, you know, maybe they were hit with some scheduling challenges with some of the things they had to do with their games. Well, I think the biggest thing is I think that we'll be extremely exciting. We have a lot of length and size and athleticism, and nothing against our team from last year. We just didn't have a whole lot of the size on the wing, especially. But our guys are extremely athletic, and I'm very happy about that. And, you know, that addressed some issues. But our guys, hopefully, and our fans will see, you know, that side of, you know, really getting out and trying to push and transition and trying to get steals and trying to finish up above the rim and be a lot quicker and faster. And hopefully that's what we show our fans. And then it's just, you know, I just think about the way that you should play. Our guys play the right way. They play extremely hard. And it's a lot of what Milwaukee is. It's you know, Milwaukee to me is a blue collar type of city to me. And I think our guys fit that mold, but also I think they also, you know, have that brand that college basketball fans love to see as well, and that's from the you know, having the athletes and having guys that can get up and down the floor and you know, hopefully we can have a few 100-point games in there. That would be fun. You're always concerned when you're going into a new season of who will bring you scoring and rebounding and all of those things, and definitely it's something that we're looking at as a team. But I think with each new year, though, brings that challenge. You know, a lot of teams throughout college basketball lose leading scorers, but then it's what do I do to help guys that I think are ready to make that next jump. And I think that we have guys that in our program that can make the next jump to, you know, I think it was similar to last year. You know, I think we had one guy that was, you know, in double figures last year that returned. And we had no one else in double figures. So I think it's the same thing this year with guys that, and we'll put guys in position to be scorers for us, and they know that. And our guys know that if they don't shoot the basketball, if they're not aggressive, then they're going to be sitting over there by me. So I think by that virtue, you know, I think our guys will be willing hunters for shots, and they'll be coming to me asking for more. So I'm looking forward to that. Well, you know, obviously we want a lot of times you want your class, or if you're a local team, to have an infusion of your local talent in here. But at the same time, we want guys who also fit how we're doing things. And while we're beating, the pavement hard on trying to find Wisconsin and those Illinois kids and even Minnesota, that area, we also have found some guys that are really good and that fit the mold of how we want to play. Athletes that can shoot the basketball, that can run and jump and do all those things. And then I think the greatest thing about our class that we have in, our newcomers, is they're all, you know, tough kids. And they all play hard, and they're great character kids as well. You know, I've learned how to say no in year two, but to me, each year is a new challenge, something different, and that's where the excitement comes in. I don't know what to expect from our guys when they're playing, in an upcoming game or a scrimmage or anything like that. So that's the great beauty of being in a new season in year two for me. So I'm looking forward to, you know, the lead up to our first game and our, you know, we're preparing for Concordia, we're preparing for Boston College and teams like that. I'm excited about that opportunity, and that's what the change is, and that's what's exciting about this new year for me. You know, Bryce is obviously, you know, our mainstay. He's been here for the longest and understands the league, understands what I want now, and he's been very good for us. And, you know, the one thing that I've asked him to do is knock down open shots, don't turn the basketball over, and you know, he's been doing that in practice. And, you know, we have Darius Roy, who, came over. He's a recruit that we got in from junior college ranks, that's very quick and tough, and you know, he can shoot the ball as well. So I think we have two very good point guards that if I call them into action, that they'll perform for us. And very excited about both of them. And even at times we've messed around with big lineups with, you know, playing Bobby Arthur Williams at the point at 6'7", which I think that he's capable of doing. He averaged 17, 10, and almost 5 assists last year where he came from. So he has the capability in pinch moments or different settings to run some point for us as well. So I'm excited about that position, and it's the hardest position in college basketball, in basketball, period. And, having played that position, they understand, you know, the demands that I have on them as well to if they're not perfect, try to be as perfect as possible. Well, I think obviously our guys that have returned, you know, Vance Johnson, I think he's improved. He's improved his body. He's improved his ability to shoot the basketball from the perimeter. We still want him to hang out down low and create his niche in the paint as well. Carson Warren Newsom, he's a kid that, you know, played multiple games for us last year and even factored in a lot of our wins last year. So, you know, I think that, you know, he'll be more of a recognizable name. DeAndre Abram is a kid that, that sat out last year. He transferred from George Mason, and, you know, he's 6'8", he's about 205 pounds, and really, he's made a great transformation of his body, of his mind, of his attitude from, you know, the first time that he set foot on campus to this point. And I'm excited about him. I mentioned Darius Roy and obviously, you know, Bryce Barnes and, you know, those guys. And then we have, you know, Bobby Arthur Williams. He's a multi-versatile type of player for us that I'm encouraged by some of the things that he's shown in practice. I can go on down the line about a lot of our guys, but I truly won't know until we're faced with adversity where maybe we're up in a game and hit some adversity, and now I really know, you know, how they'll respond against an opponent in a game that really counts. You know, it was funny, and Elijah, you know, he's been really, really good for us. I mean, our guys love him, and they can't wait to see him in practice, and I think hate to see him sometimes too because he's so strong. But, you know, the timing for him was last spring he had talked to me about coming on board, and I said, you know, you have to talk with your coach, your baseball coach, and make sure that's fine with him. And then through some other things, found out, because he was on scholarship, that he couldn't come on board with us. So I kind of dropped it. And then after that, he said, Coach, he said, you know, I love baseball, but I love basketball as well. And fortunate for him, you know, he had talked with his baseball coach and his family and about still wanting to pursue this dream for him. And I said, the baseball coach has jurisdiction over you, so whatever you decide, whether you're giving up your scholarship or whatever in baseball, that's something that you have to talk with your family and your coach about, and I'm going to stay out of that until the end. And, you know, he came back after that and said, Coach, I want to be in. So we had a two-day tryout for him in the summer, and it was amazing some of the things that he did out on the floor and most of it on the rebounding end. And I can talk about that later. it means so much to have Tijon in our program. He's been great since he stepped foot on campus, and I knew when he became when he decided that he wanted to transfer and ended up coming here, that I knew he would have an impact in our program, and not even just playing. You know, he has the experience playing at the highest level in the Big Ten. He has the toughness. He has just that Milwaukee toughness that I love, and he's made a true impact all the way around in our practices and off the floor. And I know our, you know, Darius and Bryce Barnes, they really appreciate having him as well, because while it's a competition, he also talks to them and helps lead. And same thing, you know, with all of our point guards from that standpoint. You know, they're going to be able to learn a lot from him as he sits out, and he can see the action as it unfolds and help them when I'm standing up and maybe talking to our guys on the floor watching the action. While if they're sitting out, he can be out talking to those guys. But he brings an infusion and great high energy into our practices. He's one of the toughest defenders that I've been around. Reminds me, I don't want to sound too arrogant, but reminds me of me, just how I wanted to defend and try to take that position out of the game. And that's who he is. And then on the offensive end, he's really getting better. And then from a leadership standpoint, he's done a great job. Yeah, I'll be remiss and I apologize to Jake for not mentioning him as somebody I think that can make an impact. You know, I think that he can really impact us in many ways. And the first part is his leadership. You know, I think, you know, I've had an opportunity to be around him prior to him being here at Milwaukee. And I knew what I was getting from him. I knew I was getting a leader, probably one of the hardest workers that we have in our program. And then you couple those things with his ability to shoot the basketball. And, you know, I've never met a kid that works as hard as him. He's in the gym in the mornings. He's in the gym in the afternoon. After practice, he's in the weight room. He comes back in the gym. And to top that off, he still has his studies. He's, you know, getting his master's degree. So, you know, someone that you have in your program like him, whether he scores 20 points or scores 0 points, you know, I still think you need to have guys like that in your program. And the culture that we want to have here, he sets the tone with you know, some of our other guys that we have in our program as well. But I love him as a kid, love him as a basketball player, and, you know, to me, he's worth 5 wins. You know, it's going to be time will tell with those guys, because we have some older guys that, you know, have kind of established themselves and almost set themselves apart in a way, but they're still open competition. But someone like Shea Mitchell, who, you know, has size, he's 6'7", he's really athletic, he ran, you know, he jumped high jump in track, and really tremendous athlete. And but also with that, he can shoot the basketball. So we're seeing if he can come in and fight for, you know, fight for position and fight for playing time. Another kid, Jamar Madge, is from Kansas City, and, you know, I've been pleasantly impressed and surprised by his development from the time that he got here until today. I mean, every single day he's improved and gotten better. And he's pushing our guys. He's charged with guarding, you know, Jake a lot of times in practice. And, you know, in those first few weeks, Jake got the best of him. And we were trying to teach him a lesson. And I think he's slowly but surely gotten the message. And defensively, he's gotten better. And then I think he's a capable offensive player too. But it's gonna take some time with them to really understand what college basketball is about, the sense of urgency that you need to have, and just the work ethic that goes into being a really good player, let alone just a college basketball player.